So yesterday we started how to use one sample t-test. So we will come to the sample hypothesis. Two type of hypothesis we can hear. One is H naught, the second is H1 or H alternative. This depends on the organization. They can use H alternative or H1 they'll use. H naught is nothing but null hypothesis. When you are coming to the organization, the baseless information. For example, I can produce my plant can produce 1 lakh laptops in a minute. There's no, evidence for that. So with an evidence, by taking a sample, and if you are going to be estimate about population, the evidence, once you get it, that evidence will represent that H naught or HA. I'll say in my school all students IQ is more than 100. That is the statement I given. So that doesn't have any evidence. So we'll say we will represent all students IQ is more than 100 or equal to 100. H1 or H alternative is always trying to give a answer with an evidence by your statistical analysis. So IQ might be more than 100 or less than 100, whatever it may be. So here we'll try to represent, or we'll come up with a solution saying that IQ is not equal to 100. Or some scenarios we'll say IQ is less than 100, or some scenarios I can say IQ is more than 100. In some scenarios I can say IQ is not equal to 100. Depend on the situation. For example, if I'm into clinical industry, when my scientist is innovated a new tablet, before tablet and after tablet, there should be some results, and the tablet should minimize the problem. For example, like a crocin. So before crocin and after crocin. Before crocin, the fever should be like 100 or 110, 101. After taking tablet, the levels of fever should be come down. So that scenario, what we'll do is, before crocin, the temperature should be not equal to so and so. We will represent there is a changes, the changes is lesser than for the population. Are you getting, anyone is getting or confused? So depending on the problem, we will use not equal, lesser than or greater than, whatever maybe we can use. So when I use a single one like lesser than or greater than, we will call it as a one-tailed t-test. If they say not equal, that means either the results might be more or less. Anything can happen. So this is called two-tailed t-test. When you are representing less than or greater than, that means you are referring only one part. The rest of the less, when you are representing greater than, that means you are skipping the less than. So that is called one-tailed t-test. And if you say not equal is nothing but either it could be more or less. So that is called two-tailed t-test. Let me show you. Now in a school, district A states that has a high school have 84% pass rate on the high school exit exams. A new school was recently opened in the district, and it was found that sample of 150 students, I'm not representing population, sample of 150 students had pass rate of 88% with a standard deviation of 4%. Does the new school have a different pass percentage rather than other schools? At 0.05 level, we have to answer. That means 95% confidence level. 0.5 is nothing but beta equal to 95. So that is the thing what we discussed yesterday. Your H naught will represent with alpha. Your H1 or H alternative will represent with beta. This is a significance value. This is either a Z value or a T value or a chi square value or F value or so on, so any value depend on the problem set. This is always a 0.05%. When it's 0.05%, that means it's a 1 minus 0.05, that is nothing but 95%. So when I'll accept my alternative, when I can reject my alternative, means when my Z value, T value, or significance value, chi square value is 95 or above, then I'll accept alternative. If my alternative value is lesser than 0.95, that means automatically my significance value is above 0.05, so I reject my alternative. Either I can accept or reject my alternate hypothesis based on my significance value. So you can see here my null hypothesis is nothing but blindly everyone saying that with a baseline without any evidence, saying that 85% is the pass percentage. So my mu equal to the average marks for each and every student is on an average 85% marks. My alternative is nothing but not equal to 85%. It can be more or it can be less. Now if you see here, there are three different slides I'm trying to show. So at alpha equal to 0.05 means, so alpha equal to 0.05 they mentioned, that means not equal that any. So not equal means 2.5% lower tail and 2.5% upper tail is an error. Rest of the any value which comes under is this 95% level, we accept and we assume alternate hypothesis is correct. If any one value fall under 2.5% above or 2.5 in the higher side, that means we are going to reject alternate hypothesis. Sorry, we are going to accept the alternate hypothesis. Here we are going to reject it. So these are error values, error area, and this is the actual area, the significance values. Any questions on the slide?
Can you explain the type 1, type 2 errors?
Not yet discussed, so do not worry. I not yet come to that level. I'm talking about just the basics of hypothesis. Do you understand that or not?
Yeah, hypothesis, null and alternate, yeah, we are getting this.
Fine. Now,
build back the origin.
Yesterday we discussed about one sample t-test. One sample t-test in the sense, when you have a single sample and estimate and compare with the mean of a population, then we will call it one sample t-test. Today we will discuss about a paired t-test. Paired t-test There are two types of weight distribution we have. One is within the groups. The second one is between the groups. These are two examples we see today. Yesterday we've taken only the reliance, right? One sample. Now let us take crossing before and after example. Crossing tablet before the temperature and after the temperature. So when assume that the scientist innovated a new crossing tablet, the next version of the existing crossing tablet. Now they started testing on a couple of people whether the crossing tablet is working or not. So before the crossing tablet, what was the temperature, and after crossing tablet using, what was the temperature? Now they want to compare it. So when you compare only with the means, you can check, or with the variance you can check. Right now, all the hypothesis what we are doing with the means only, compares the means. Now I want to check, because of crossing tablet, whether the temperature was come down really, actually, or not. That is my question. There might be a chances, except one or two people, the temperature might be more. Here they didn't mention, the temperature might be more. So those are exceptional cases, we'll see. But if you see here, for everyone the temperature was come down, or they maintain the same. Now you are responsible to identify whether there is really a change there. So what is your H naught? Question or someone, what is your H naught? So before crossing and after crossing.
Equal to 100.
Here I'm not telling 100. Can I say my null hypothesis is nothing but there is a change before person and after person, right? And H1 is nothing but there is a change before person, the temperature is not equal to after crossing. That is one way I can tell. Or if the company says that no, there should be a change after crossing, the temperature should come down, then I'm going to follow null hypothesis, this one-tailed test. So before crossing, temperature is greater than after crossing temperature. So one-tailed test I can follow if I want. So depending on the problem statement, you have to decide one-tailed t-test or two-tailed t-test. Now again,
this, what is null hypothesis?
Null hypothesis is nothing but before crossing and after crossing, there is no difference in temperature.
Yeah.
And alternative is nothing but there is a temperature, difference in temperature. And here there are two ways I can take a alternative hypothesis. I can say there is a difference between temperature. That is one way. The other way is the temperature before is greater than after, because after taking tablets the temperature has to come down, then only that means the tablet is working. Are you getting what I'm trying to say? The tablet can work in two ways. Either it can minimize your temperature or maximize your temperature if it's giving some side reactions. So you need to be ensured with the problem statement whether you need to take single one tablet test or a two tablet test. If it's a clinical industry, you need to be very cautious about this. Before temperature should be more than after temperature, because after temperature the value has to come down. The temperature has to come down. So now I'm going to compare. I'm going to be check comparison between two different groups. Options at 95% level. Now you tell me what you understand from this. Anyone? So I have a paired t-test. I am within the groups. Now you tell me what you understand from this. The average before it was 100, the temperature after taking closing, the temperature was 97. And the sample what I taken is 30, and the deviation is this much, and the error in our data is this much. Now, the correlation is not discussed, so forget about this. Now, what is the difference I have before and after mix? 100 minus 97 is nothing but this value. The difference is this much I have. And confidence level, what is the difference for approximate difference between before and after is this much. T value is here. And the degree of freedom I'm comparing with when I have degree of freedom is nothing but you're taking one sample in your hand and comparing with other samples. So when I say I have 30 samples, one sample will be in my hand, and rest of the 29 samples have freedom to rotation for comparison purpose. So degree of freedom is nothing but n minus 1. Now significance is, what is the significance here? 0.00. That means I can accept null hypothesis or I can accept alternative hypothesis. Which one?
Null hypothesis.
Null hypothesis I
can
accept. No, alternate hypothesis I'll accept. There is a difference, right?
Yeah, it is showing lesser than 0.05, right?
Yes. That means I'll accept the alternate hypothesis, no?
Okay, right. Alternate is greater than 95%, right?
0.95 and above is alternative. 0.05, significance value is 0.05 or above is called as alternative is rejected. Alternative is rejected is nothing but indirectly you are accepting null hypothesis. So this value is 0.00. That means almost 99.9999% you are accepting alternative, right? Which is above 0.95. Are you clear?
Now, yes, sir.
How much strong you are accepting your alternative hypothesis? That is also important. So, if the value, the T value or Z value or F value, whatever you have here, the value whatever you have here, is it closer to 1.96 or not? If it's very close to 1.96, that means it's a weak, it's not that much strong, I'm going to believe. If it's instead of six, one digit, if I have something like 10 or 20 or 30 or 180, some value which is far away from 1.96, so the strongness will be increased. So right now I am accepting there is a difference with level of 95% confidence, and that is not that much strong confidence interval. It's just at 6.9. it's not that much strong. Are clear?
Sir, can you repeat it once again?
How much strong you are going to be confident on your answer or solution means, if the t value is closer to 1.96, because 95% confidence is nothing but 1.96. Correct. So
yes, got it.
The t value is a closer to 1.96 value. So I'm okay. I'm happy with my solution, and significant value is low. So it's a weak confidence. I mean, it's less confidence we have. It's very closer to 1.96. If the t value is something like 30 or 40 or 100 or 200, that means you have a strong evidence. With this evidence, I'm strongly I can recommend alternative hypothesis is good. So the level of confidence, you can see it here. It's just a 6 value. Closer to 1.96. Are you clear? Any questions?
Well, what is this difference? DF 29, how do you got that?
DF is a degree of freedom. So when you are giving a comparison between one variable, one input, one observation to other 30 observation, because we have 29 30 observations here. So what you will do is you will start giving the comparison of the means with one observation to other observation. So that time you are holding one variable or one observation in your hand. Rest of the 29 observations have a freedom to change it for comparisons. So degree of freedom always will consider as n minus 1. When you are giving the comparison of the means. Are clear or not?
Yeah, but what is the role it is playing here? I mean,
so
we are not getting any.
No. There is a lot of information in degree of freedom, but right now I am not covering because that is a purely statistical concept which I need to go in detail.
So now as the value is 0.000, so we are agreeing, we are accepting the null hypothesis. Right?
Alternate hypothesis.
Because, what is that?
Alternate hypothesis. See, when I have 0.000, it's nothing but your alternate hypothesis up is equal or above 0.95. Right. So, and your if you see the significance value is if you will accept your null hypothesis only when the value is above 0.05, but the value what you got is 0, so which is lesser than 0.05.
Okay.
So you are accepting alternate hypothesis, or if for example if the value is 0.06. Automatically, your significance value is the confidence level in significance value is 0.94, which is lesser than 95%. So, I will reject alternative hypothesis. When I say rejecting alternative is nothing but indirectly, I am accepting null hypothesis.
Okay, what we taken as null hypothesis here, what is the condition? Is
so, you can say. Before and after before tablet and after taking after taking Crocin, that there is no difference in temperature.
That is the null hypothesis.
Null hypothesis. Alternative is nothing but there is a difference. But here there are two ways you can take. There is a difference between before and after taking Crocin. Or you can say other way, the Crocin. Before taking Crocin, the temperature is more than after taking Crocin temperature, because it has to come down, right? The temperature has to come down. So one tell test also you can consider.
So I mean, at the beginning of this assignment, so what is given to us, and I mean, we were given the temperatures. So what is asked from us? What is the expectations from us?
So they will ask you, for example, assume you are working for some pharma industry. Once they innovate a tablet, they will test on somewhere around 50 or 100 people, and they'll see the temperature and they'll give it to you. Can we continue with this tablet, or can we, we require to modify anything in this tablet? So once you get the database, you are responsible to fix a hypothesis what the tablet contains, whether it is going to minimize something or maximize something. So it is a tablet like a cruising, the temperature has to be come down, right?
Yes.
So the hypothesis is something like, there is no difference. First, as a baseless information, what we'll do is null hypothesis, there is no difference in temperature before and after. The alternate hypothesis will mention saying that after taking tablet, the fever is come down. So that is the thing what we'll do. There is another type of tablet which is elevated to increase the stamina or physical strength in our body. So that time, your alternate hypothesis might be, after taking tablet, the strength is more than before taking a tablet. Clear, right? So depending on the problem statement, either you can take a not equal, or a greater than, or a less than. If you say greater than or a less than, that means you are following one tail t test. If you are saying not equal, that means you are following a two tail t test. Amar, I don't know the difference between one tail t test, two tail t test means. Let me show you how it works. Here, this is called two tail t test. The error we can find, we are going to check monitor in the left side and the right side. It's a less than, it's a greater than. Not equal means. If I following only the greater than value, then I'm going to be check only the upper side. I'm not going to be consider my lower error. So that time the values are going to be changed. You do not worry where I can go and check the values. The system is going to propose the values. Based on your significance, you can decide whether you need to accept alternative or reject alternative. But conceptual wise, you need to know whether you need to take one tail or two tail.
Okay. What will happen if significance value exactly equal to 0.05?
Obviously 95% we are accepting. Yes. So alternate hypothesis.
Okay, we'll go for alternate.
So that is the reason, if you see the question, at 95% level I want alpha equal to 0.05. That means 95% confidence level. The question is alpha equal to 0.05. That is the standard question we'll ask. If you are coming to clinical industry, they may ask you to go for 0.01 level. That is nothing but 99% confidence.
So, okay. So alpha beta is null and alternate.
I'm sorry?
Can we consider we are calling is alpha beta, right?
Yes, alpha beta. So that is here spelling mistake, beta.
Alpha beta, we are just considering as other names for null and alternate hypothesis.
So that no. Alpha beta is the terminology which you are giving for these values. But the statements you are giving with alternative and null hypothesis, H naught and H1, or H naught, HA. So these are the statements what you are writing. So before cruising, the temperature equal to after cruising. And alternative hypothesis HA or H1, there is a difference. Or you can say before cruising temperature is greater than after cruising temperature. So this is the statement you are going to be write down. Now for this one, what is the alpha value means? The significance value, you will maintain 0.05. This is the beta value. Beta value is nothing but 1 minus alpha value. So 95%. These are the statements, and these are the alpha and beta values.
And what is this ZTCHIF coming?
Actually, based on the data, based on the given data, if it's numerical data or if it's a categorical data, we have different type of test we are going to be follow. If you see here, the test shows as T test, because when the sample is lesser than or equal to 30 sample, then system automatically consider as a T test. The same test, if you have more than 30 samples, will consider as a G test. So do not worry whether it's a T test or G test or F test. Concentrate on significance value, then you will work from your solution. So forget about this one. Right now, assume you know only G and T. When you are comparing a two different means and the count, the sample what you collected is less than or equal to 30, you follow T test. And when you are comparing a means of two different samples and the sample count is more than 30, you will follow G test. And you are comparing two different variables or the samples, and you are comparing the variance, we are going to follow ANOVA test, nothing but F test. Are you clear? Variance is F test, the sample count is more than 30, and comparing the means G test, and comparing the two samples where the sample size is less than 30, less than or equal to 30, we will call it as t-test, student t-test. Are you clear? Are any questions?
Yeah, but these are picking up by the system, right? We are not assigning or we are not seeing anywhere that less than 30 count.
No, system automatically. There is a reason we are telling, machine learning knows. System knows everything.
But so now the data we are working is on, is the count is 30?
Yes, you can see here, 30.
Okay, total count is 30.
So n value is 30.
Okay, if it is greater than 30, it will automatically go for Z test.
G test. Okay. Clear, right?
Yeah.
Now, the same thing we'll try to do it in R also. One sample t-test and a pair t-test, both. Assume the persons who wants to bypass the code just come to packages and load the package called RCMDR. RCMDR is a package to use GUI, graphical user interface, like SPSS. Instead of typing everything like a programming, you can use GUI, and the GUI will generate a code for you. Whatever you did so far, whatever you learned the 4 day session, you learned a basic programming with descriptive modeling. The same thing without learning also, I can generate a code. Now I want to import the data first. So import the data from Excel sheet or from Stata, from Minitab or SAS or SPSS or some THT file. From anywhere I can import the data. So I can import the data. Data set name. I'm saying OK. And I will import from the same data, like a before person, after person. I have three different sheets in that, so I'm taking one sheet. So you can see here, data set one is the variable name what I entered, and I read the Excel sheet from the so-and-so location. And row names are false means I don't have any row names, and header equal to true. I have a header. NS are filled with blanks. Sheet name is decoding, because I have three different sheets in my Excel. So the sheet which I selected is decoding. Strings as a factors equal to 2. So if I have any test values, that will consider as a categorical variable for analysis. Now I see view data. So the data set, whatever I shown in Excel, the same data set you can see here. Now what are the things I can do is, if I go to statistics, you can go for tabulations, contingency tables, one way table or two way tables, and comparison the means. Compare the means what? One sample t-test, two sample t-test, paired t-test, or ANOVA, or anything. Comparing the means. And if I go to graphs, any graphs, whatever you discuss, like box plot, or density plot, bubble chart, anything, for example, histogram. Histogram for any numerical data. So, lens I take. And if you want to give some labels, you can give some labels, x axis, y axis, and the table name for your graph. Say, okay, the histogram is created. Now, for that histogram, what we use, a command called histcurve, the variable name. So, the same thing, hist of variable name and the scale equal to frequency, break equal to structs, color equal to dark gray. Instead of dark gray, you can give some other color, the color will change. So the code automatically generating, then what is the problem? Everything will copy and paste to the IT department. So if you want something else, like the dot cut is not stem and leaf for lens. So stem and leaf is created. So you can see stem.leaf is the command. And for that, for generating a stem and leaf, the package is whatever you required, system automatically unpacked it. So in the given data set, what are the models I can implement means? I cannot implement any model here. Distributions. What are the distributions I can do? Continuous distribution, Poisson distribution, or a binomial distribution, T distributions. Everything works. Now we are in the process of comparison the means. So I see single sample to test, the Reliance Smart. So the system is showing pick up any one. So Reliance Smart is the example which we discussed. Our null hypothesis is the population we discussed yesterday, 25 cases per rice bag. Now you can see population mean is not equal to sample mean. Population mean is lesser than sample mean. Population mean is greater than sample mean at 95% level. 0.95 level we are trying. Now, based on the problem statement, like we just now as we discussed, whether one tail or two tail, we are going to decide here. And say okay. Now you can see T value you got it, and degree of freedom you got it, and P value is 8.888 exponential of 5. That means what? My value, my p value, this p value is nothing but significance value. Here, since the tool is different, the way of representation is different here. So t value you have and the p value you have. P value is nothing but significance value. When you see 8.88, it's not going to, this is significance. They are given exponential value. Exponential of minus 0.05 means after five zeros, 8 value is coming. So 0.00008. That is not acceptable, right? And you can see the confidence level estimation of at 95% level, none of the values are equal to. What do you say? 95%. The population mean, population weight at 95% level, the values will be this much. So alternate hypothesis is true. And they say that my alternate, my true mean, my what is the mean is true mean is nothing but my sample mean is not equal to 25. The representation they are giving like this, so it's not, don't be confused, that they are trying to say true mean is nothing but the mean whatever you calculated right now is not equal to 25. It will be acceptable when it was 24.12 or 13, whatever the discussion. Are you clear? Similarly, when I go to compare means and parity test, I am giving comparison between two different variables. So before and after options, two-tailed t-test at 95% level. Now, if I say two-tailed t-test, that means there is a difference between before crossing and after crossing. Or if I want to go for one-tailed t-test, we have to say either difference less than or equal. Now you can see the values, t value this much and significance value this much. So the same thing what you seen here. T value is 6.903. So instead of saying in 2 decimals, they mentioned in 3 decimals, 4 decimals they mentioned. 6.9029, nothing but equivalent to 6.903 almost. Degree of freedom is 29 and the significance value is 0.0000 after 7 decimals. One value will come, nothing but significance value is same value. Any questions on this? And estimation of the confidence at 95% level, 1.82 to 3.366. Now if you copy this code and share it to your IT department, that is more than enough. What else you need to know? Here you have a code, here we have output, here we have XML code. XML code also we can share if they want. Anyone have any questions on this? Hema, Shadabji, Sagar, Vinay. Question. Any questions? So if you're okay, we'll drop for the day. Tomorrow we will plan rest of the hypothesis, whatever we missed, like a type 1 error, type 2 error, and comparison between the groups within the group we discussed, between the groups we not discussed. So that one also we'll discuss tomorrow. After finish that, I have a couple of assignments on hypothesis for you. Thereafter, we are going to enter to ANOVA. There, your question, Roshan, the degree of freedom we'll discuss. There we have technical stuff where we are going in detail of ANOVA, how the ANOVA calculates. Any questions on this so far? Okay, we'll drop a call for today and tomorrow.